In the last video, we have learned what is not-profit organization and how do they generate their income. In this video, we learn capital receipt, revenue receipt, very important capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. Let us start with capital receipts. Receipt first. Receipt means what? Income. The income that is received, the money that is received by the organization, we call it as receipt. It may be a capital receipt or a revenue receipt. Capital receipt, very simple. These receipts are non-recurring in nature. Revenue, these receipts are recurring in nature. Non-recurring means what? The receipt which is received only once. We don't get that income again and again from the same person or from the same source. That is called as a non-recurring receipt. Revenue receipt means the income that is received again and again from the same source. In the last video, I had given you some examples of incomes. Here, let's see it. Non-recurring life membership fees. The fees that we receive in lump sum from the members is received only once from that member. So that becomes a non-recurring receipt. That is called as a capital receipt. Life membership fees. Whereas subscriptions, what are subscriptions? The annual membership fees that we receive from the members, that means from that person, every year we receive the fees. Every year we receive, that means that is recurring, that has to be a revenue receipt. Then, special donations or grants. For what purpose we receive the special donations or grants? For a specific purpose. To construct a building, to purchase the books, or for any other, there is a purpose given. There is a purpose behind collecting that donation or receiving that grant from the government. That is called as non-recurring. When you receive, it's like when you receive the money to construct a building, it's but obvious. To construct that building, you received the donation only once. Now, when the non-trading persons or the members come to your office and say, "Sir, we are constructing a hospital building. We would like to get some donations from you." Fine. You give them a check of 5 lakh rupees. After 2 or 3 months, if they again come and say, "Sir, we are constructing one more building, another 5 lakhs, will you give?" No. That is given only once. So we say that is the income that is received only once, which is non-recurring in nature. They don't receive that again and again. Whereas, general donations means what? Small amount donations. They're not of huge amount, small amounts. When the persons come to you and say, "Sir, we run a charitable trust. For that, we need some donation," whatever amount you like, you give some 100 rupees immediately. Fine. After 2-3 months, when they come and they say, "Sir, 3 months back you had given us 100 rupees. We need some more money." Fine, this time you will give 200. 100, 200 can be given. That is what? General donations. Without any purpose. You receive that again and again. That is called as recurring. Recurring means that has to be a revenue receipt. Now, legacies. What are legacies? Property received as per the will of the deceased person. That is on the death of the donor. How many times should receive the property from the as per the will? Once. Person dies once, will receive the property once. So legacies are going to be your capital receipts, because that receipt which is received only once. Not only legacies, endowment fund, which is usually of huge amount, that also becomes your capital receipt. I'm just collecting those which we have discussed in the last video. So here, capital receipt, what is it? Non-recurring nature, like life membership fees, special donations or grants, legacies, endowment fund. They are always capital in nature. revenue which we receive again and again. Examples: subscriptions, general donations, rent received. Rent received from let out property or sale of any old newspapers. These are the incomes usually that we receive again and again. These are all called as revenue receipts. So in short, what is a receipt? Money received by the organization. What is capital? Which is received only once, non-recurring in nature. What is revenue? Which is received again and again, which is recurring in nature. After this receipt, the very important concept is expenditure. Expenditure, money spent by the organization, can be classified into capital and revenue. First we'll see what is capital, then we'll move on with revenue. What is capital expenditure? A expenditure is said to be capital if it fulfills any one of the following three conditions. Number one, a new asset comes into existence. Improvement to the existing asset. Discharge of fixed liability. New asset comes into existence means when you purchase a new asset, like, say, purchase of land, purchase of buildings, purchase of any furniture, etc. When you purchase a new asset, land, building, plant, machinery, furniture, vehicles, computers, motor cars, whatever, we call that as a new asset comes into existence. For what purpose you have purchased? Business or private, immaterial. A new asset is purchased. First condition is fulfilled, that expenditure has to be a capital expenditure. Further, improvement to the existing asset. Improvement means not maintenance. Improvement means we should do something to the asset in such a way that the value of the asset should increase. Maintenance will not increase the value of the asset. Now, for example, the bike. You give your bikes for servicing. Suppose if you have purchased a bike for 50,000, 5 years you use the bike, and in that 5 years, every year you have spent 1,000 rupees on its servicing. So after 5 years, when you are selling the bike, can you claim 50,000 plus 5,000 for servicing charges? Servicing charges will not increase the value of your bike, because servicing is done not to improve the bike but to maintain the bike in a good condition. Whereas 50,000 bike purchased, if you modify the bike, if the bike is modified with some magwells, some new headlights, some new handle, then you get more money for that. That modification is called as improvement. That is called as improvement to the existing asset. One more example. There is a ground floor building. To that ground floor building, if you paint, whitewashing charges are done. The ground floor building is, say, for example, 25 lakhs value. After whitewashing, you say now the value is 30 lakhs, 35 lakhs. Is it possible? No. Why painting, why whitewashing is done? To maintain the building in a good working condition. Suppose to that ground floor building, if you construct first floor, obviously the value of your building is doubled. Ground floor 25, first floor 25. You can claim 50 lakh rupees when you are selling the building. So improvement means the value of the asset should be increased, such as I said, constructing a first floor to the ground floor building, or modification of equipments. This is improvement. What is improvement? To increase the value of the asset, what you do, that is improvement. To maintain the asset in a good condition, what you do, that is maintenance. Maintenance and improvement are different. Third, discharge of fixed liability. Discharge of fixed liability means a very simple non-recurring expenses. The expenses which are paid only once. The expenses which are paid only once are called as non-recurring expenses, which are not paid again and again are called as non-recurring expenses. Like when you purchase land, when the land is purchased, you need to get it registered in your name. To get it registered in your name, you have to approach the sub-registrar, the government office, get the formalities done. And once the formalities have been done, the sub-registrar will sign the documents. And that will not be done free of cost. You have to pay the registration fees. You have to pay the stamp fees. So this registration and stamp fees paid, how many times you'll pay that? Only once. When you're purchasing that particular land, on that land we paid only once. So that registration and stamp fees becomes a non-recurring expense. Non-recurring means which is paid only once. That is non-recurring. A simple example for non-recurring. When you purchase a television set, you require some means of transport to get that television set from the marketplace to your house. We cannot carry that in the carry bags. We need some kind of transport. Suppose if you hire an auto rickshaw driver, he gets the television set, you give him 200 rupees as a transportation, auto fare. Next day when you see that same auto rickshaw driver, will you call him, come here, yesterday we had taken a TV, you had got a TV, again take 200 today, will it happen? No, that is paid only once. What is paid only once is called as non-recurring expense. So this is what is a capital expenditure. What is capital expenditure? An expenditure is said to be capital if it fulfills any one of the three conditions. A new asset comes into existence, improvement to the existing asset, discharge of fixed liability. Any one condition if fulfilled, we call that as capital expenditure, or else that is not a capital expenditure. Now the next question is, what is revenue expenditure? Very simple. Don't develop any conditions for that. When expenditure comes to you, check out, is it capital? Yes, take it as capital. It's not capital, we take it as revenue. What is revenue which is not capital? As simple as possible. Don't develop some conditions, huh? When no new asset comes into existence, when there is no improvement, when there is no discharge of fixed liability. Remember these three conditions for capital expenditure. And then, what if it fulfills one of that? Capital, if not, it is revenue. So this is what is regarding capital and revenue. This part is very important when you're learning not-profit organizations. Because as we proceed further, there are the accounts to be done. Income and expenditure account. In that account, only those items are to be taken which are revenue in nature. If it is a revenue receipt, we enter in the account. If it's a revenue expense, we enter. Capital items are ignored from income and expenditure account. Where to take it, we'll see. Then at that time, when you're preparing the account, you should know whether it is capital or revenue. And that is the reason why one has to be perfect with this part. In this video, we have learned what is capital expenditure, what is capital receipt, revenue expense and revenue receipt. In the next video, we'll take up few problems and classify whether it is capital or revenue items. Thank you.